Hello developers, how about a font specifically designed for developers? Yes, we have Jetbrains Mono, a font for developers as the title says. Here you can see how it looks like in our usual consoles font that we're used to it and Jetbrains Mono font. So definitely we're getting more readability on Jetbrains Mono than consoles, but noticeable point is the font size. In both case, the font size is 13 pixel, but we're getting more readability on Jetbrains Mono. Jetbrains Mono also introduced ligatures to add something new to your tech profile. You can see the new look of some of the most commonly used symbol pairs in programming languages. As I turn on the ligatures on or off, you can see the changes it brought. Curious to know how your favorite language will look like in this new font? Here we go. Beside the font itself, we can see changes like the ligatures here and there, including in the arrow sign and then the less than equal sign. Oh, this is something common in every programming language. And on Java, nothing noticeable here. In Go, we have the nautical to sign and the spacing between them. You can see in Python, we have the equal sign. And in C++, we have the angle bracket and the spacing between them. And in C#, the lambda sign. Yep, all this to improve the readability of our source code, right? Jetbrains Mono also solves a problem that we face sometimes with some of the font. Like in some font, it's very hard to differentiate between 1, L, and I, and also between 0 and O. But here you can see it's very easy to differentiate between 1, L, and I, and also 0 and O, because inside 0 there will be a dot, but in case of O there will not be a dot. So you can easily differentiate 0 and O next time. Enough talk. Let me show you how you can install this font, and then I'll guide you through the setup with Visual Studio and Visual Studio Code. So either you can install the TrueType or the variable font, but I'd prefer to go with the variable font. So you had option to right click and install, or right open it up and then you can click on the install to install it. In that case, you have to install two of them. Other option would be to search for font setting. I have it here already. So then I can just simply drag and drop them. Drag and drop them to here and it will install this font. To verify whether the installation was successful or not, you can just search for Jetbrains here and we can see the Jetbrains Mono, right? So we have successfully installed Jetbrains Mono. Now to set it up on your Visual Studio, you have to go for Tools, Options, and then you just search for Font. And just make sure you have text editor selected here and just search for Jetbrains. So I'm pressing J only and I got Jetbrains Mono already. Also, you can change the font size if you want. So I usually prefer to go with 13 pixel and just press OK. Alright, so in my case, I have installed this one previously, so I didn't have to restart my Visual Studio, but in your case, you might have to restart your Visual Studio, and you can see the changes already. The lambda sign here. To set it up on your Visual Studio, either you can go for File, Preferences, Setting, or you can press the shortcut, Control, Comma, and then just search for Font. And yeah, you can remove these consolers. Just type Jetbrains Mono and also ensure the font ligatures are on. So here, if it false, change it to true and it should work. Yeah, we see the ligatures already, and yeah. So that's it. Thank you.